The subject was Uri Geller, a young Israeli who claimed to have supernatural powers.
His remarkable affinity for metal and his psychic abilities are well documented all over the world.
In the early 1970s, Geller became a superstar, the most famous psychic in the world. And then, of course, there was Mr. Geller's appearance on The Tonight Show. I got a call after they booked him to appear.
Would you welcome, please, Uri Geller.
Johnny had been a magician himself and was skeptical. I was asked to help prevent any trickery.
Nice to see you.
Thanks.
We have only met.
This scares me.
This scares you? Well, this is just, we just got some things together here.
I told them to provide their own props and not to let Geller or his people anywhere near them.
Also, one of our staff members did some drawings which have been sealed in an envelope, and I'd like you to take your own pace when you feel like you want to try anything.
Right.
Do you want to try that particular experiment first?
When all feels right.
When
okay.
You sure.
We start eliminating the ones that do not have the word.
No, without touching them.
He is really suspicious.
No.
I'm having a hard time with you.
I don't mean to be, right? I really don't.
Just keep looking. Okay, let me rest a little, all right?
All right.
You know, I'm surprised because before this program, the producer came and he read me at least 40 questions you're going to ask me.
Well, I can ask you all kinds of questions if you'd like me to ask you questions.
I have to have time.
Dark, we're back. Your Uri was telling me you don't feel what, strong tonight?
I don't feel strong. It's not all tonight. Right now I'm feeling being pressed and then I can't.
Well, I'm not trying to press you, I really not.
Telling me, well, will you try that or that?
Well, I thought that was the idea of I'm not trying to put you down.
Central to the mystery.
mystical Kabbalah belief written in the 13th century. The Zohar describes what is called the Ancient Days as providing the manna. But what was this Ancient of Days? A man? A god? Or something else? The text speaks of different sized brains, different sized faces. They were connected with different tubes and different light sources. Theologians have suggested that this is the description of God. However, when looked at from a modern perspective, what is described in the Zohar isn't necessarily a god figure, but rather a type of machine. Intrigued by this information, two electrical engineers, George Sassoon and Rodney Dale, used the anatomical descriptions of the Ancient of Days to design what they called a manna machine.
This red is the key diagram of the manna machine as we built it up from the texts. For instance, one here is the mouth, but it's actually the air intake, which carries what is described as the breath of life. Air goes up this tooth here, which is described as the brain of the ancient one, but is actually the dew stone. So that although we're talking about the seed in the head and the beard and so on, at the same time we were able to work out their relative positions, build up the specification of the machine, and find that we had something that was biochemically viable.
Diese Maschine hatte einen Ansaugspitzen. The machine took in moist morning air and condensed it in part of the machine that looked like a plexiglass dome. From there, it mixed with an algae culture. The culture was treated with energy, such as a strong laser light, in order to speed the growth.
Of course, it needed energy for cultivating the algae, and this was produced, we postulate, in a small nuclear reactor which would produce both heat and light as required.
Die Manna Maschine war wahrscheinlich... The Manna Machine was a very dangerous device. We suspect that the reactor that powered the machine was transported in the Ark of the Covenant. We have multiple references in the Bible that whoever came close to the Ark of the Covenant and didn't know how to operate it was smitten to death. And sometimes people, after they encountered the Ark, started to lose their nails and started to lose their hair. So we have evidence of some type of radiation poisoning which was in direct correlation with the Ark of the Covenant. And so the Ark of the Covenant housed the extraterrestrial device which was given to the Israelites during their 40-year wandering.
supplied a highly nutritious form of green algae, or chlorella, as its food source. It's yet another theory supported by modern science.
We found that work in the field of space travel had already been done, where the green algae chlorella was bred in tanks and fed to people living in the closed environment and kept them alive.
Research studies done by NASA in the 1960s and 1970s established that human life could be sustained for extended periods of time by consuming chlorella algae and nothing else. If it's possible for astronauts to survive on algae, could the Israelites have done the same?
Meine Maschine war ein...
The Meine Maschine was a sensitive device. In order to function properly, it had to be cleaned once a week. On that day, the machine was taken apart and cleaned. So it's possible that the Sabbath we have today actually originated from cleaning this machine.
One theory that one could put forward, of course, is that the machine, although they knew how to maintain it and make it produce the manna, that it did after time pack up, not work anymore. That was why they came out of the day.
Perversion, you sinful man. I crucify you.
I see the wonders of the day. Millions of people left like clay. Millions of whispers saying, I'm dying. Mother, I see the wonders of the day. Millions of people left like clay. Millions of whispers saying, I'm dying.
Thank you. earth beneath under my feet. The giant curse made of concrete. I said I'm happy and I'm dying.
Desperation, understanding, destination isn't ending. Desperation, understanding, destination isn't ending. Get the sword, get the sword.
I love paintings.
Well, I'm sure Hansa loves you too.
Truth was born in a thousand meanings, and I was made from evil spinnings. Like Jesus said,
that it did after time pack up, not work anymore. And that was why they came out of the desert.